Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to Cash Money Matters. And today I'm doing this video on my couch. It's looking amazing. I feel more relaxed here. And you know, this is the first time I'm doing a video on a couch. And it's very comfortable, very easy, very simple, very informal. Otherwise, guys, welcome to Cash Money Matters. And here, as usual, we talk about the money mindset, how to make that money, how to manage that money, how to enjoy that money, how to invest that money, and how to assure yourself of a consistent income for a lifetime, basically financial freedom, people. So welcome to Cash Money Matters, and today we're gonna be looking at something in real estate. So those of you who love real estate, this is the video for you. If you don't like real estate, you can still listen, because then you get to learn certain things. Therefore, you can help someone, or you can just become knowledgeable. Sometimes we seek knowledge for the purpose of knowledge. Otherwise, guys, if you haven't subscribed to this channel, please make sure you subscribe, please, and smash that like button. Thank you to those who have supported me this far. I appreciate it. I don't take it for granted. And I know we're going to 100,000 in less than 2 years. That's a good goal, right? I'm just 3,000 now. That's a big goal. That's a big goal. That's a big target. Thought it wise to talk about off-plan property investment in Kenya, because it's something that's very popular nowadays, even though it comes with lots of risks. We need to change our mindset with regards to investing, because we were taught certain things when we were growing up. We haven't actually challenged the ideas we picked when we were growing up from our parents or from the people around us. So real estate generally has been a good investment everywhere in the world. It's still a good investment. It makes people rich all the time. It's a good investment. I can never take that away. You will hear a lot of people have made money in real estate, but you won't hear of how many people have actually lost money trying to get real estate. And that's what we're going to discuss. We want to look at these things realistically, so that investors don't end up getting into things they don't understand just because they're popular. So one of the things we were talking about when we were growing up is that real estate is good, land is good, which is an investment that everyone wants to have. They just want to buy land. Sometimes you don't even know, why do you want to buy land? Do you want to develop it? Do you want to do something with it? Some people are just buying land for the sake of it. So I always tell young people, don't just rush into buying land, rush into buying houses. Make sure you have a very clear foundation of why are you buying it? What are your objectives? What are your goals? What are your financial foundations? What are your financial values? Come and speak to a finance coach, speak to a financial advisor. Let them tell you, where are you at the moment with regards to your financial journey? And are you in a safe position and in a safe ground to start investing in certain things like off-plan real estate or even just normal real estate? So I always tell people that it's not just about owning land and owning houses that is going to make you rich. No, it's about having a very clear financial journey, a very clear financial objective, a very clear financial goal that's going to make you rich. It's not a sprint, it's a marathon. Otherwise, a lot of people then end up losing a lot of money in these plans, wasting a lot of time, and then they now end up with lots of court cases with no money, and they are still poor. So what is off-plan real estate or property market? Basically, it's whereby you buy property that doesn't exist. It can be residential. Most of them are residential or retail. Not so many of them are industrial or commercial, because there are different types of real estate. In Kenya specifically, most of these off-plans are basically residential houses. People are buying them as homes. Some are buying them to as investments so that they can rent them out, or they can sell them for higher prices for different reasons. One thing you must understand with off-plan is that you are buying something that doesn't exist. So you are buying something that has been proposed to you, and then the developer will develop it over time. And then within a period of time, you're supposed to pay an amount of money in installments, and they should deliver that house at a particular timeline. Now, it never happens like this all the time. There are so many risks that come with off-plan that people haven't been properly educated about. And even if they have been educated, they are ignoring those risks when they want to get into this plan, because sometimes they sound too good. It is a cheaper way of getting into real estate. The reason why off-plans are here is actually because it's cheaper to get into real estate through an off-plan payment method rather than just buying a full house that has been built already and you can see it standing right there. So what are some of the risks that we need to look at when we're going off plan? So just like I mentioned, basically if you're buying off plan, it means you're going to require a deposit, maybe a percentage of the house price, and you're going to pay that deposit to the developer. And then after paying that deposit to the developer, you're supposed to pay the remaining of the installments over a period of time. But like I said, that the property doesn't exist. So you're hoping that the developer will deliver at the time they say they will. So there are so many risks that people haven't actually looked into with regards to off-plan, and this has really affected so many young people, specifically speaking. Because I know many people have put lots of money and lots of time in this off-plan real estate. So number one thing that you need to look for is, are you going to actually make money out of this thing? What about the opportunity cost that you may be losing out of it? Because if you're going to be contributing, let's say, 100,000 every month for a particular house, you've already given a deposit of, let's say, even 500,000, you're going to be paying this house for a period of time. Are you taking more risks and you could get into the market and get better returns for your money? Because if you do not do that kind of analysis and look at the market and see, can you get better returns somewhere else? If you invest this money, the 500,000 plus the 100,000 Kenya shillings, our example, that you're going to be contributing every month, is it possible that you could get better returns somewhere else, which is much safer and gives you more peace and you're sure of returns than this kind of development plan? That's number one thing. I want young people to look at the opportunity cost, calculate it, get to know what you're actually going for, get to know the risks you're taking on, get to know if there are other options available for you based on your investments objectives. If there are other safer options available for you, then I would say avoid taking risks that you shouldn't take. Avoid losing that opportunity cost whereby you're going to tie your money for a very long time while not even sure of the delivery of the project. The second important point is that most of these developers do not deliver as promised. And this is a problem that we've had in Kenya, and not just in Kenya, even in Europe this problem exists. But in Kenya and in Africa, it's on a large scale, because there are no structures that can actually get these people to pay for theirs. In Africa and in Kenya specifically, you find that most of these developers have a very nice model house that you go and see, and you know, it's really nice, but usually they don't deliver what they actually promise. So sometimes they deliver something that's more substandard, and therefore you end up losing money trying to renovate the house, make it better, or go to court and stuff like that. It's just not worth it. Most of these developers have become very corny, and therefore they want to fleece you out of your money, and they don't deliver whatever it is they promise. So that's one thing that you have to understand, that not all developers will deliver. But how do you go about that? The only way to go about that is make sure that you are working with a developer that you know, that someone that has actually done the same thing, and you can talk to some buyers, you can talk to people who are living in their current projects. If they have any completed projects, you need to go and see them. What is the standard? The people living there, what are they experiencing? So it's important to know your developer. Be very intentional in knowing who is developing that particular project. That's number one. Number two, you need to make sure that when you're sending any documents for an off-plan, you have a lawyer who can go through the details of the document. The reason why so many investors lose money in Kenya is because nobody wants to read those documents. And there are usually so many things in those documents, so many details that protect the project manager or the developer, but do not protect you as an investor. So if you don't take your time and go through those things with a lawyer and someone who understands real estate, then you're likely to lose in case there's a court case. So before you sign any document, and get into any long-term plan with the developer, make sure you have a lawyer who can go through your documents and can certify that everything in there is okay and attainable and legal. A lot of Kenyans overlook these things because they don't want to spend money. The funny thing is, people don't want to spend money on the little things, then they end up losing millions and millions of money. So like people, I tell them, come for finance coaching before you invest, come for financial advice before you go and invest. They don't want to pay you, let's say, 10,000, 20,000 to come for investment advice, but then they go and invest and lose millions of money. So it's the same thing. If you can't pay a lawyer some money and protect your property and your future, then chances are you will lose, and then you will come back crying, all this company. No, sometimes we have to take responsibility as investors. So another risk is basically sometimes these developers are unable to deliver on time. Like I said, opportunity cost. So if they are not able to deliver on time, that's a problem already, because you have a particular time frame to start getting your money back. You have been spending money to putting it in an investment. You want to give it a particular time frame, and therefore you start getting whatever you have been putting in back to you. So if the developer doesn't deliver, but you have been paying consistently, it means you're losing money. You're losing money and you're losing time, and time is even more expensive, and you cannot start afresh. So most of these developers, they cannot deliver on time. That's why I'm saying, make sure you know the developer, make sure you get so much information about the developer and everyone involved in there, because sometimes these developers are just the front face, but there are some other people involved in the background that may have very dented images. So make sure you know everything about the developer and those working around that developer, because there are different sections. You can find that there are suppliers, there are architects, there are engineers, there are different, all these are different companies that are coming together to help this developer develop this property. So make sure you have very clear information about such people so it can help you get an understanding of the whole project and how likely it is that they will deliver it on time. I know people have been waiting for 10 years for houses to be delivered. 10 years, if you are getting rent for your house, you would have made a lot of money back. So make sure you have that information and please do your research well. Another thing that you should ensure as an investor is you need to know the financial structure and the funding plan of the developer. Most of the developers in Kenya are now just coming up from nowhere and asking Kenyans for money so that they can develop. It should not be your money that's used directly to develop. Your money should just be security. They should have funding that can actually develop those real estates of those properties without your money. So you also need to know what is the financial standing. It's just like you want to buy a stock and you want to know the financial standings of a company. What is their funding? How they are going to get money that is going to use to be develop these particular properties? Don't think that it's your money that should be relied on fully to develop that property. That's why most of these developers do not deliver, because they rely on money from investors to develop. And the money from investors is never a lot of money. It's just the deposit that is paid and that monthly installment. These are some of the questions investors don't ask, and then they end up in the ditch. If you cannot ask these questions, you need to find someone with the knowledge to ask these questions for you, or to tell you what are the things you need to look out for before you start investing in an off-plan real estate. And then finally, of course, there are just fraudulent people. They are just fraudulent developers who have disappeared with people's money. They basically tell you that they're going to build a particular project, and then when they have collected the deposits, they have collected the money over a period of time, you start chasing them up and down and they just disappear. That's possible. So sometimes they just don't deliver anything. They just basically take your money and it becomes like a Ponzi scheme and they disappear into thin air. That is a very huge possibility in a country whereby institutions haven't worked so well for most people. So you have to be very sure. Like I said, you have to make sure that you go deeper and know about the developer's history. So just a recap of everything that we've said. We've said basically that off-plan should be something you may look into. But if you are someone who doesn't have a very clear financial foundation, don't go into it just because people are going. Go into it with very clear objectives. And we looked at some of the risks that are associated with it and how you can mitigate those risks. We have looked at some of the risks associated with it and how you can mitigate those risks. So make sure that you do everything based on the plan I have given. Make sure first you have a clear financial foundation, you have a clear objectives and goals and why you are going into this. That's number one. Number two, if you decide to go into it, make sure you know the developer very well. Make sure you go and visit people who are actually living in the projects that they have completed. Make sure you talk to lawyers, you talk to people who have actually worked with them. If you have done that, make sure you work with a lawyer to help you through the process. If that is done, make sure that you are updated on what's happening with the developer. So all these things should be done like I mentioned clearly. So all those ways, if you do it in that way, then you mitigate certain risks. It doesn't mean you eliminate all the risks. Definitely, it means you mitigate most of the risks that you are likely to experience with off-plan real estate. But most of the time, before you even go into that investment, talk to a finance or talk to a financial advisor. Let them tell you if you are ready to take that kind of risk. We basically assess your risk attitude, and therefore we advise you based on that. We also assess your financial foundation if you're safe to take such a risk. So it is important to talk to some professionals before you get into such off plans. But a lot of them have been scams. That's the truth. Just make sure you're very careful. Make sure you're very intentional. If you decide to go into it knowing that there are certain risks you're taking and you're willing to take those risks. We've also looked at the benefits of an off plan, which you've said it's cheaper, of course, because it's paid in installments. You can pay it over a long period of time. And of course, if the developer is authentic, you can end up with very high quality products. So guys, I hope this was helpful. I hope it can get you in buying your next property if you're going to buy some. And it can also help in making the decision to do it or not to do it. Thank you, guys. Make sure you comment. Let me know your thoughts below. And as usual, Kenya's Money Matters here. I see you in the next video.